students there is pleasure to start today with a topic that I have. It is weather and climate. You see different weather and climate during the year. Today is our chance. In the Bible we find in Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 1, it says, to everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven. In other words, there is time for everything. Everything has its time. Okay.
How's the weather?
It's sunny.
How's the weather?
It's sunny.
How's the weather?
It's sunny.
It's sunny today. How's the weather?
It's rainy.
How's the weather?
It's rainy.
How's the weather?
It's rainy.
It's rainy today. How's the weather?
It's cloudy.
How's the weather?
It's cloudy.
How's the weather?
It's cloudy.
It's cloudy today. How's the weather?
It's windy.
How's the weather?
It's windy.
How's the weather?
It's windy.
It's windy today. How's the weather?
It's snowy.
How's the weather?
It's snowy.
How's the weather?
It's snowy.
It's snowy today.
Okay, we finished the song. It was, how's the weather? Is the question, ¿cómo está el clima? How's the weather? Here, if I ask you, how's the weather? You can answer, it's sunny, it's rainy, depends on the place where you are. For example, we are here in Panama. Estamos aquí en Panamá. When I ask you, there are two seasons. Hay dos estaciones nada más. We have rainy season, we have dry season. Estación seca, estación lluviosa. Okay, how's the weather? ¿Cómo está el tiempo? Okay, this is the question. As objective, we have to compare seasons in Panama with seasons in other parts of the world to describe the weather during specific seasons. In Panama, just we have two seasons, but in other countries, there are different seasons. For example, in USA, we find different seasons. We find winter, those seasons, but here we are going to compare. In this vocabulary, we are going to pronounce different words, drizzle, stormy, cloud, it means la nube, windy, cloudy, lightning, sunny, soleado, rainbow. You can find that, you can look it up in your dictionary. Snowy, thunderstorm, rainy, snow, rain, hot. That word is lluvia. Hot, caliente, caluroso, cold. Okay, this is the puzzle that you are going to do. You are going to find different words that we have learned from the vocabulary. Here in Panama, we have two seasons. As I said, rainy season, dry season. And on the left, we have rainy season, on the right hand we have dry season. Here, you can see here, this is the rainy season here. And here the season, dry season. But as I said, in different countries, there are different seasons. You can find summer. Here, we have summer here. In this picture, you can see summer. And the next is, yes, this is summer. This was spring. And the next picture illustrates winter, invierno. Some people say that in Panama we have season, winter season, but not. Algunas personas dicen que en Panamá tenemos el invierno. Eso es absurdo. El invierno no existe en Panamá. We have rainy season. And the other is autumn, otoño. Yeah, that is. Now we have to clarify this part. It's about adjectives for weather. Estamos viendo los adjetivos para el tiempo. Aquí vemos que los adjetivos siguen un orden. Siguen un orden. Puede ser de primero o puede ser de último. Aquí vamos a ver la estructura. ¿Cómo describir el tiempo? Ustedes van a usar esto. Los adjetivos va primero y luego le sigue el sustantivo. Este primer ejemplo dice, it is a sunny day. Para reconocer cómo está el orden, debemos saber cuál es un adjetivo. Aquí tenemos una lista aquí de adjetivos hacia abajo. Aquí tenemos sunny, soleado, windy, snowy, rainy, stormy, cloudy, foggy. Todas estas palabras son adjetivos. Y aquí la palabra que funciona como sustantivo está la palabra day, la palabra día. Entonces, el orden dice adjetivo más sustantivo. Entonces aquí está el adjetivo que sería sunny, soleado y día. It is a sunny day. El día es un día soleado. Aquí tenemos la misma función otra vez. El adjetivo de aquí en esta oración es rainy y el sustantivo seguiría siendo day. Pero en otra cosa más podemos invertir. Podemos solamente poner un verbo, después un adjetivo. En este caso, el verbo to be está aquí. En las dos oraciones está el verbo to be. Pero aquí desaparece el sustantivo. Solamente ponemos un verbo y el adjetivo. Here we have, it is sunny, está soleado. Esa es la oración más fácil de hacer, está soleado. Puedes poner, how's the weather? Con la pregunta de la canción, how's the weather? You can say, it is. Y ustedes van a elegir cualquiera de estos adjetivos que está por aquí. Puede ser, it is sunny, it is windy, it is rainy, it is stormy, it is cloudy. Dependiendo. Entonces, esta es una práctica que pueden hacer para entender. Repásenlo varias veces. Now we are going to read. Summer is my favorite season of the year. On sunny days, my family and I do outdoor activities such as going to the beach or the river. Sometimes we make teams and play sports at the beach. Beach significa playa. We prefer to go to Atlantic Oceans, Oceano, Atlantic, Oceano Atlántico, beaches, playas, plural. Because they are very calm and quiet. Silencioso, tranquilo. Even though we like sunny days, we also enjoy the rainy season. On rainy days, we enjoy some indoor activities such as playing cards or chess or watching movies. On cold days, my mother bakes cookies. Cookies, esta es la palabra que significa galletas. And make hot chocolate. Chocolate caliente, hacen chocolate caliente while we listen to music or watch TV. Mientras escuchamos la música o vemos televisión. Right now we have to stay home because of the COVID-19 lockdown. However, we always enjoy our family time. Lo que leímos acerca de esta lectura fue el tiempo familiar. Que lo que se puede hacer en las actividades afuera, en tiempo de, en diferentes estaciones, ¿qué se puede hacer? Ahí están todos. Hoy mismo estamos en casa a causa del COVID-19, así que disfrutamos del tiempo. Now the activity one says, what is the title of the reading? ¿Cuál es el título de la lectura? You are going to write. The title of the reading is Family Time, period. You are going to write with capital letter. Capital letter is the big letter. Es la letra más grande que deben usar. La mayúscula. Number two says, mention two indoor activities that family does on sunny day. Usted va a mencionar dos actividades que se hacen dentro de las casas durante los tiempos soleados, la estación soleada. Mention two indoor activities that family does on rainy day. Dos actividades dentro de la casa que se puede hacer durante el tiempo lluvioso, días lluviosos. Number four, what are the favorite dishes of the family? ¿Cuáles son los platos favoritos de la familia? Those is in the reading. Todo está en la lectura. Why do the family stay home these days? ¿Por qué la familia permanece en casa durante estos días? La respuesta está en la última parte que ya leí. Due to the COVID-19, because of the COVID-19 lockdown. Ahí aparece todo. So I'm going to read again. Activity number two, fill in the blanks. Aquí ustedes van a llenar. Two seasons in Panama are, as I mentioned, yo mencioné two seasons we have in Panama. You are going to fill that. Solamente tenemos dos estaciones en Panamá. And here the seasons in other countries, las estaciones en otros países, que no es parte de Panamá. Mention two activities you and your family do during summer. Las actividades que hacen durante el verano. Dos solamente. You are going to write one on the next. Mention two activities you and your family are doing during the lockdown. ¿Qué están haciendo durante este tiempo de pandemia? ¿Qué hacen? Te van a poner dos. Activity number three, fill in a blank with the correct adjectives. Aquí van a usar la estructura de la parte adjetivo más sustantivo o verbo más adjetivo. Van a poner en práctica lo que yo ya les expliqué. The dry season in Panama is very hot, cold. ¿Cuál de esos va a funcionar? Aquí tenemos el verbo y aquí le sigue un adjetivo. Así que van a escoger cuál de esos funciona. La estación seca en Panamá es muy...
¿Es muy qué?
Caliente o frío. Ahí está. Dry season, la estación seca. ¿Cómo es? Por supuesto que nos sudamos, pero no de frío. It's because of the hot. Rainy nights. Las noches lluviosas are... Cold, warm. ¿Son cálidas o calientes? Yo, you are going to write that. Van a escoger solamente un adjetivo que identifique el contexto. People prefer days to go to the beach. Los días para ir a la playa, ¿cuáles son? ¿Rainy o sunny? Okay, you think about that. Think. In Boquete, the mornings are. In Boquete. ¿Cómo son las mañanas? Snowy, foggy, ¿cómo está? You are going to write one of that. That's all. Okay? Thank